Okay, now we are going to see about network topology and transmission medium. Network topology. What is a topology? Topology is an arrangement or a structure here which describes the arrangement of the computers in a particular network. Network topology means how we are arranging elements of communication network. It could be a physical arrangement or a logical arrangement. Whereas physical arrangement is an arrangement which we can physically see them or which we arrange it manually. Whereas logical arrangement is a consideration how the data flows in the network. And this is the difference between physical and logical topology. Where physical topology, placement of various physical components of a network. Whereas in logical topology, define how data flows within the network, which defines the architecture of the communication mechanism for all nodes in a network. And there are various types of topologies. First one is the star topology. Here, in star topology, the server is centralized, dedicated point-to-point link to a central control, which is the server. Devices are not directly linked to one another, whereas it is all the devices are linked to the central server. The link is dedicated. The link carries traffic only between the two devices, that is the sender and the server, that is the client and the server. Advantages of this star topology. Its robustness. If one device fails, only that link is affected, whereas all the other devices in that particular network function seamlessly. And it is less expensive. It is less connection needed, easy to install, and easy fault detection can be done. There are several disadvantages for the star topology, and they are: if central device fails, entire system is dead. Since it is centralized, if the server is not up, and the whole system is down, doesn't allow direct traffic between two devices. Any devices in this network have to make the communication through the server. They cannot directly communicate with each other. The controller acts as data exchanger. So here, if there is any communication between any two devices in the network, the central server acts as the data exchanger between those two computers. And next, it is the ring topology. Each device has dedicated point-to-point connection with only two devices. Here in ring topology, all the devices are connected to the nearby two devices. That is, a single device is connected to at most and at least two devices. Only single pass, first packet reaches to the destination, only then the second can transfer. So only one way of transmission can be done through this ring topology. It can be un- or bidirectional. There are some advantages and disadvantages for the ring topology. Whereas when it comes to advantages, it is easy to install since only two devices connected to a single device, and it is less expensive. And any node failure doesn't affect the entire system. Here, we don't need any central authority to maintain it. So if any one device fails, it can use the another device as a link to the destination node. And it has some disadvantages. If any fault in the bus cable, then it stops the entire transmission. So at least one node which is connected to a particular device should be active. As signal travel becomes weak when it goes long. Since it is a ring topology, to establish communication between any two devices, there should be a number of devices in between those two devices. And when the signal travels through all these intermediate devices, the signal becomes weak. Next comes the bus topology. Bus topology, it is a multi-point connection topology. Link is backbone to all devices. That is, there is a single main central link. To that link, all the nodes in the network will be connected. It can install limited number of nodes. There are some advantages and disadvantages. Whereas when we come to advantages, it is easy to configure because there exists only a single network communication in which all the devices are connected. Add or delete a device requires changing only two connections. That is, a device can be easily added to the network because the single network of this topology is already established, and easily it can be removed without affecting other nodes present in that topology. Fault detection is easy in this topology. and the disadvantage is any fault in the backbone cable will disable the entire topology. This disadvantage is similar to the star topology, where a server acts as the central main thing for the topology. Here we have the backbone cable, that is the single cable which acts as the main network, main node for the entire network. If any faults occurs in it, the whole network will be down. Next, there is a mesh topology. Mesh topology is an interconnected topology where one device is connected to all the nodes in that existing network. It is a dedicated point-to-point link to every other devices. Here, all the devices are fully connected. The node 1 must be connected to n minus 1 nodes, and node 2 must be connected to n minus 1 nodes, and all the nodes follow a respective manner. Finally, n must be connected to n minus 1 nodes. For example, whereas the whereas one node is connected to all the other nodes except that node, since the formula is formulated as n minus 1. And this this topology has some advantages and disadvantages. Whereas we come to advantages, no workload. Each link carries its own data. So if a communication should have to be done between any two nodes in this network, only that particular link is used to communicate. So there will be no interference or any other blockage by the other communications by the other nodes in the network. It is robust. If one link fails, it doesn't affect the system. There are multiple options available to that particular node to reach the destination node. Privacy and security. Since a dedicated link is provided without the interference of any other node between two devices, the data can be transferred securely, and which enables the concept of privacy. Fault identification and isolation is very easy in this type of topology. When we come to disadvantages, it is costly. Since we are using many cabling or I/O ports which is required by all the nodes, and we have to establish many number of links between the devices, and which costs money or time or any other resources. Reconnection and new connection are difficult. Since if we introduce any new node into the network, we have to make that node connected to all the other existing nodes, and which is a complicated task by compared to the other topologies. And while even by removing the node from that network, it is also a tedious task. And this network is complex, since it's while the number of nodes in a network increases, the complexity also exponentially increases in this topology. And next, we are coming to the transmission media. Whereas this transmission media acts as a link between the nodes which we saw in the network topology. With this transmission media, we establish the network and the data communication towards any nodes. A transmission medium is that can carry information from a source to destination. For the transmission medium, for two people having a T connection, it is like any two computers transferring data. And for the transferring data, we might use a cable, or it might be a wireless communication, or any type of transmission medium. And let us see what are the types of transmission medium. The transmission mediums are divided into two broad categories. They are guided and unguided. Where guided transmission medium, all the links are established through wire. In unguided, it is done wirelessly, that is without any physical wired connection. And under guided transmission medium, we have twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. But under unguided wireless transmission medium, it is a free space through which we communicate, through which the communication is established in the air. Guided medium. This provides the channel, that is the physical wire channel, from one device to another. As we discussed, there are three types: twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, and fiber optical cable. These transmission mediums are directly connected to the physical layer of the node. Twisted pair cable. It consists of two conductors with each one with each own plastic insulation twisted together. One for carrying signal and another for ground reference. there are two types of twisted pair cables. One is unshielded, another one is shielded. Next. These are the different these are the different specifications required by the twisted pair cables in different establishments, whereas it is used in telephones, T-lines, and local area networks in different specifications. And each specification has its own data rate. It varies according to how it is established. Application of twisted pair cables. It is used in telephone lines to provide voice and data channels for DSL, that is digital subscribed lines, for local area network, that is LAN. Next one, let us see about coaxial cables. This carries signal of high frequency ranges that those in twisted pair cables. Central core conductors of solid copper wire enclosed in insulating shield and then wrapped in a one more conductor sheet. All are wrapped in outer insulator. This is the structure of the coaxial cable. We can see the outer jacket which provides insulation from outer, and there is a braided shield, and then there is a foil shield, and then there is a dielectric, and then there is the central connector which carries the information. There are general three categories of coaxial cable. They are RG59, RG58, and RG11, where RG59 is used in cable TV, and RG58 is a thin Ethernet, whereas RG11 is a thick Ethernet. Applications. They are used in telephone networks, cable TV, and Ethernet LAN, and there are several other various applications. Next, let us see about fiber optic cables. This is the most widely used transmission medium in the local area network. It is made of glass or plastic. Transmit signal in the form of light. The light is transferred through this medium, which might be a glass or plastic. And this is the structure of the fiber optic cable. It contains an outer jacket, and that is a strength membrane, which makes the inner glass or plastic more flexible according to the requirement. And there is a coating to insulate it from the strength membrane, and there is a cladding, and there is a core. This core transfers the light from the transmitter to the receiver. Applications. These are the backbone network in for the wide area network. A long range of connection are established with this type of network because it is more reliable than the other types of network, and it is faster in transmission. Some cable TV companies also use this kind of networks to transfer the data. Advantages: higher compared to the other transmission medium, it has the higher bandwidth, and it has the immunity to electromagnetic interference. So no interference can affect the transmission, whereas in other copper or coaxial type of cables, there might be any interference affecting the transmission. And this is lightweight while it comes to plastic or glass is used. And there are some disadvantages, which is the cost. It is expensive compared to the other two types of mediums. It is unidirectional light propagation. Since through the medium, we cannot transfer the light from the both the sources, and hence it is unidirectional in nature. Next, let us see about the unguided media. In guided media, we use some physical medium to transmit the data, that is wire. In unguided media, we don't use any physical medium, that the data is transmitted in air, that is wirelessly. It is transported in the form of electromagnetic waves. Signals are broadcast through free space and thus available to everyone. So there need not to be any individual connection between a two particular node. Any node within the range of the transmitter can access the signal, and the communication can be established. Unguided signals can travel from source to destination through ground propagation, sky propagation, line of sight propagation. These are the three kinds of propagation used to transmit the data wirelessly. And there are three different wireless waves used, like electromagnetic waves. They are radio waves, microwaves, and infrared waves. Propagation methods. And there are these three types of propagation methods, and they have different ranges and frequencies related to each type of propagation. Radio waves. They are omnidirectional. When antenna transmit waves, they are propagated in all directions, and hence they are known as omnidirectional. A sending antenna sends waves. Receive can be any antenna. The receive any type of any antenna which is in the range of the transmitter can receive the signal. The frequency in which it operates is 3 kHz to 1 GHz. It propagates in sky mode and long distance mode. And the applications of radio waves are useful in multicasting, AM and FM radio, television, cordless phones. Advantages: it is good for long distance broadcast, and the disadvantage is radio wave band is narrow. Wireless transmission waves, another wave is microwave. It is unidirectional in nature. Sending and receiving antenna should be aligned. So if the alignment changes, there might be interference in the transmission, so it must be in aligned. The frequency in which this transmission operates is 1 GHz to 300 GHz. It has a wide band, whereas in radio waves we have a narrow band. Antenna should be long so that no one can interfere. Some applications of microwaves are useful in unicast, cellular phones and satellite networks. And the advantages is good for one-to-one communication, and the disadvantages is it requires huge antennas and it should be in directed way to establish the connection. And next there is an infrared waves. Frequency, the infrared waves operates in a frequency of 300 gigahertz to 400 terahertz. High frequency can operate, cannot penetrate walls. So this infrared waves range is very less compared to the other waves. Antenna should be long so that no one can interfere. Some of the applications of infrared waves are in short range communication, whereas it can be used in wireless mouse, keyboards or any nearby remotes or any other kinds of devices to establish short network, short communication. And the advantages are good for small range communications, no interference within a room. Disadvantages is uses for long distance communication, as it can be established only in shorter communications. That's it. Thank you. Sir? Hello, sir.
Yes, Vikash, completed.
Good morning, sir.
Okay.